Well, after a season clouded by its fair share of controversy, it was perhaps fitting to finish with a penalty that will be debated for many years to come. Joining me tonight to discuss that and much more are Socceroos Craig Foster and David Zdrilic. And live from Brisbane, championship-winning goalkeeper Michael Theoklitos. Michael, welcome to the World Game and congratulations on your fourth winner's medal in four grand finals. You must be feeling great today.
Yeah, thanks, Les. It's something that I'm obviously proud of. To have played in four grand finals, it's very rare that you manage to play in them and to obviously have four wins to go with it. So something I'm personally proud of and something I'm obviously proud of to go back-to-back with this playing group.
OK, well, we're going to talk more about the game and how you won it with what kind of tactics, etc. in a moment. But let's get the penalty out of the way and I'll get the boys' view in a moment. But what was your view? I know you would have been a fair distance from it, but how did you see it at the time that it happened?
Yeah, obviously, as you said, Les, it was quite tough for me. He goes on the other side of the field. But look, speaking of Besh, he definitely believes he received some sort of contact. And by obviously him receiving that contact, it put him off balance and fell over. And look, you know, as a striker, I think when you're 5 yards out in front of goal, I'm sure you'd put the ball in the back of the net if you could. So, obviously it's a tough call on the referee. He's got to make that call, and full credit to him for making it such a tough call with obviously the last kick of the game. So at the end of the day, I think we're just happy that the result went our way and we got our rewards for the whole year, not just the one game.
All right, Driller, the overlays are up. What did you think?
Look, this is an amazing decision. It's taken us in the office so many hours looking at it to try and think what happened. So I can only imagine what Jared Giller was thinking there. But look, when you slow it down, you can see that he was clipped ever so slightly, but he was clipped, and you can see his leg actually his left leg is pushed inward. So that's his standing leg. Then he takes a step. He actually clips the ball a little bit, which is even harder to tell. And that's probably a lot of people won't be able to see that. But he clips his leg. It goes inward. That's his standing leg. And a lot of people were saying it was a dive. It wasn't a dive because he's tried to shoot. He's tried to have a shot at the ball. And it's a total air swing. And I think that's because he's clipped the ball with his just ever so slightly with his left foot. And then he's had a total miss hit with the right foot. And it's very hard to see. And look, a lot of people are going to say they can't see this. And even when you slow it down, it's not conclusive. And, you know, people are saying there was a bobble here and whatever. But I think it was an extremely difficult decision. I personally think that he was clipped. I think the footage, when you slow it down, does show there's going to be a lot of people that disagree. And already on my Twitter feed, I've been copying all kinds of abuse. But in saying that, it was a difficult decision. And
Foz, your view?
I think he took his balance away.
I think it was definitely a penalty. I think, firstly, there's no way there was a dive. Even if there was no touch, and when I saw it live, dive didn't come into the equation. He was off balance, he tried to shoot and went down. So there's no inference of a dive whatsoever. Take that off the table. Secondly, the real question is, was he impeded enough to put him off balance and go down? It's clear from the vision that he was. And at first roll in live, I think it was a difficult call. It was a big call. And it comes down to whether the referee had a good enough view that he could see what we saw there, because it does take you to really slow it down. Yeah. I understand that the referee did. Afterwards, he explained. No, Miller came in. I have to make the point as well that whenever you make a tackle against a guy in a position where he's about to score, he would have hit the target there without that, then you take a risk. And if you touch him, and then you put him off. He does land on the ball. The reason the ball comes up is because his foot has come down on it. So to me, in all of that, it is a very clear penalty. And I think the referee has made a very courageous call.
And we should applaud him for it. The young referee.
I agree.
We demand of them to make the tough decisions.
But I've got
and this one
say,
made it.
Can I just say as well that for players on the field, they don't get to see all of those replays and so on, right? So I thought I congratulated all the Perth Glory players because they've come into this grand final to go out, and we've been players there, and you think generally that you've been robbed. You do. And I thought they handled it with great class, all of the Perth Glory people, and I congratulate them for that.